Hello! Today I am going to introduce you to a good friend of mine named Mr. Shape Man. Mr. Shape Man is a man made out of shapes who will help us to learn how to draw a person that looks realistic. How many of you have drawn a picture of yourself that looks like this? This is called a stick figure, and a stick figure is not realistic. Let me show you real quick how Mr. Shape Man is made. First, we will start out with a shape called a trapezoid for his body. A trapezoid is kind of like a rectangle, except one end is shorter than the other. Next, we will add a smaller trapezoid underneath for his hips. For his neck, you need a small rectangle that goes right on top of his shoulders. His head will be made out of a large oval shape and will be connected to his rectangular neck. Next come his legs and arms. These are each made out of two long rectangles. The rectangle that connects to his body is always a little bit longer than the other one. Finally, he will need some feet and hands. These are the most tricky shapes to make or draw. I will be showing you how to draw Mr. Shape Man soon, but first let's practice putting him together at our tables. When I say go, you may walk back to your table group and work together to put Shape Man together like a puzzle. When you think you are done, sit in your seats and raise your hand and I will come check. Now, I will show you how to draw a person that looks realistic using shapes, kind of like Mr. Shape Man. You will be making a drawing of yourself, which is also called a self-portrait. Start by making a big trapezoid for the body. Remember, a trapezoid is just like a rectangle, except one side is shorter than the other. For a shaped person's body, the bottom side is shorter than the top. Next, you will add a small rectangle right in the middle of the top of the body and an oval for the head. For the hips, you will need to make two diagonal lines going away from the bottom of the body. Connect those two lines to make another smaller trapezoid. On the bottom of the trapezoid you just drew, start making two long, skinny rectangles that will become the top part of your shape person's legs. Make two more skinny and long rectangles coming off of the ones you just drew to make the bottom half of the shape person's legs. Next, you will need to draw 2 feet. This part is pretty tricky. I drew a curvy line for the top of the foot and a straight line for the bottom and backside. You could try drawing a half circle or a small rectangle for the shoes. For the arms, repeat the steps you did to create the legs, except you will be attaching them at the shoulder instead of at the hip. You will need 2 long, skinny rectangles for each arm. Finally, you will need to draw the most difficult shape, the hands. Hands have 5 fingers on them. I have had a lot of practice drawing hands, so I drew mine pretty quickly. But if you feel like you need some practice, try drawing a small circle with 5 lines coming out of it for the fingers. It might look a little bit like this. Once you have finished drawing the shapes for your shape person, you will start to make your person unique. Don't forget, this will become a self-portrait, which means it's a picture of you. Add details like your hair, eyes, nose, and mouth. Think back to the beginning of the year when we talked about the different shapes we could use for each part of our face. Add clothes to your body and make your drawing look like you. I can't wait to see how your Shape People self-portraits turn out. Have fun!